Hello, good evening. We're up to many things. I know what I know, if you know what I mean. I'm not aware of too many things. I know what I know, and you know what I mean. Yeah, yeah. Philosophy is a talk of a cereal box. Religion is a smile on a dog. I'm not aware of too many things. I know what I know, and you know what I mean. Do ya? Do ya? Jumping in the shallow water before I get too deep. What I am is what I am, what you are, oh what. What I am is what I am, what you are, oh what. Oh, I'm not aware of too many things. I know what I know, and you know what I mean. Do ya? Philosophy is a walk on the slippery rocks. Religion is a light in a fog. I'm not aware of too many things. I know what I know, if you know what I mean. Do ya? Jumping in the shallow water before I get too deep. Choke me in the shallow water before I get too deep. What I am is what I am, what you are, oh what. What I am is what I am, are you what you are, oh what. What I am is what I am, are you what you are, oh what. What I am is what I am, are you what you are, oh what. La la la. I say, do it. Ah. Thank you for watching. Thanks, guys. I'm watching.
Thank you.
things for watching. Spa, 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 spang chicka doy. Karaoke time.
I'm not aware of too many things. I know what I know if you know what I mean.
Ah, yung spa pa yung isa. Favorite ko.
Circle.
Init. Sobra. 3, 2, 1, come on. Me, I'm a part of your circle of friends, and we notice you don't come around. And me, I think it all depends on you touching ground with us. But I quit, I give up. Nothing's good enough for anybody else. It seems I quit, I give up. Nothing's good enough for anybody else. It seems not being alone is the best way to be. When I'm by myself, it's the best way to be. When I'm all alone, it's the best way to be. When I'm by myself, nobody else can say goodbye.
Totoo naman, di ba? Wala kang pagpapaalam kasi you're all alone.
Everything is temporary anyway. When the streets are wet, the colors slip into the sky. But I don't know why. That means you and I are. That means you and I are. I quit, I give up. Nothing's good enough for anybody else. It seems I quit, I give up. Nothing's good enough for anybody else. It seems. And being alone is the best way to be. When I'm by myself, it's the best way to be. When I'm all alone, it's the best way to be. When I'm by myself, nobody else can say me. I'm a part of your circle of friends, and we know that you don't come around.
Thank you. I do not mean to infringe anything, but I'm just here to enjoy for entertainment purposes. Please do not take it against me. I just want to sing it on my own and interpret it. I would like to say thank you to the creators of the karaoke piece. I don't own anything. I do not own any of the music, just my voice. So I want to thank you, whoever the credit belongs to. Thank you so much. Babush. So what can we say here in these times, in these trying times, like we've been to all sorts of quarantine to the point that we are all in the brink of maybe some of us. I'm not talking about the other people. I was talking about myself, that this COVID thing isn't gonna go away for this time. I think it's gonna stay with us. I think it's gonna be like the influenza. It's all about immunity. If you keep healthy, if you keep avoiding contacts, then you might not contract the disease. But I think it's gonna stay with us a little bit longer. I hope and pray it will not, because I don't know if how long will I stay sane. This quarantine is making people sick. It's giving us anxiety. And it's not an easy thing. Coupled with the extreme heat that we are experiencing nowadays, I think it's not an easy thing to live with. Being contained in your houses, in our houses, in my case, I don't really go out because in the first place, I do not have the quarantine pass. And it's a pity because I have pre-existing conditions. Like I have something in my liver, I have something in my kidney, I am hypertensive and what have you. And now I feel like it's not going easy for me these days. It's like it's making my legs turn jelly. And it's a scary thing because it just attacks me with no warning. 1 minute I feel good, the next minute I will feel like I'm gonna topple down. I feel like I'm losing strength in both of my legs. The first time it happened was when I was cooking and it was extremely, extremely hot. And I was not expecting that my right leg would feel like a jelly leg. I completely lost control of my right leg. And it's a good thing I did not fall. And then I researched, and this jelly leg is supposed to be a result of anxiety. And I have been fretting for this couple of months now that I am not able to go out and go cycling. Because before this quarantine happened, before the lockdown happened, we just have had a long ride, the two boys, my two boys, my middle son and my youngest son. We did a loop. We started from Cavite City going to Das Marinas City in Cavite. And then we went to, from there, we went straight to Cabuyao, Laguna. And from Laguna, we rested for a while during the nighttime because we arrived there almost an hour after lunchtime. And so we did some cooking and we rested. And then early the next morning, we were supposed to be out early. But then again, something happened. But before I say that, I would like to tell you that the ride during the first day was awful because we have had so many experiences with flat tires. It was a disappointing experience because our time cut short and that ride went very long and it tedious because it was supposed to end at a certain time and we did not arrive on our ETA, our expected time of arrival. And on the second day, upon waking up, we woke up at around 3 a.m. and we were supposed to leave then, but then to our surprise, the Texas Trinks bike again was deflated. It has holes and it was not a pretty sight because we need to go out as early in order for us to avoid the sun because it's almost summertime then. And no shop was open to fix his wheels. And so we waited for the shop to open. And cut the story short, from Cabuya Laguna, we proceeded to, if I remember right, we passed by. Oh, I don't remember anymore very well. Well, anyway, we passed by. What do you call it? The one in Laguna. Well, anyway, we passed by. I don't remember. Well, anyway, we from Laguna, from my eldest son's house, we proceeded to the Marcus Mansion. And it was a steep climb. And I cannot take it. I had no choice because it's the only way to reach my home, my going back to the city where I belong. And so the steep climb gets steeper and it was so exhausting, but the view was awesome. Well, then after we reached the Revpal, it's supposed to mean reverse palace because the Marcus Mansion is there. And so we climbed again, going to the People's Park. It's a park in Tagaytay City. It's a very high elevation. And so when you go up high, expect that you will go downhill, a steep one, and it's so scary. But it was not my first time to do that. It was my second time because the first time was in Caibiang Tunnel in Pico de Loro, I think it's in Maragunda, but it's somewhere in Cavite also. And so what I'm saying here is that from Tagaytay, we went down to Tagaytay Rotonda. When you go to Tagaytay and you see the signage, it says Rotunda. It's U, Rotunda. But I think people were just accustomed to saying Rotonda because every city that has a Rotonda is Rotonda. And so, ladies, I mean, my friends over, I forgot, I'm on Facebook. Good evening. May isang nagtsatsaga sa akin nanonood. Salamat sa'yo. Oh, no. My laptop died. Oh, no.